What I can do here is I can click on that, just pressing investigate, then allows me to use these custom prompts that I've made with the context that I've given it. To me, that's just a little bit frustrating, right? Like Notion's a $10 billion company and they can't add basic things like knowledge uploads or custom Notion AI personalities. Like, add those yesterday. Notion AI just kind of sucks. What? Who said that? No, listen. It doesn't suck. I don't want to be mean. However, I just don't get it. I just don't get where their vision is at, right? Like, what are they trying to do? I go into Notion and I go into my homepage and I press Control P. I have Taskade AI. I've been using it for a little while. I even purchased that bad boy. Guess what? I don't use much.
Notion AI, because it feels like a complete waste of a purchase at this point.
So I can ask questions about my workspace. Like with Q&A, so I can be like, what are my different video editor's names, right? I just ask, like, who are my video editors, like if I'm new to the team. And yeah, guess what? This is partially correct. These are some of the editors that I have. I don't even know who this is, to be honest. Like this just doesn't work, right? Like I literally have a database called Team Directory, right? With filled out people. And I'm not gonna untick this because I wanna keep the people I have private for the most part. But there's a list of a bunch of people in there. How could they not? You know, there's a role, right? And it says like editor, right? How can they just back into it? Oh, he has a list of junior editors. How do we, let's just tell him the list of junior editors that's in his Team Directory database. That sounds like, why do we have databases if you can't reference the information well in databases? What's the point, Notion? Why is that even a feature yet? All right, sorry, I don't want to rant. But seriously, when I interact with new pages, you know, and I get answers that are wrong, what I then struggle with is the fact that with AI, I could brainstorm ideas about a list of YouTube videos for productivity app-based content, right? I could write within the platform. That's cool. That's great. You know what I can't do? I can't add any knowledge whatsoever as to the context of anything outside of this page. Tell me why. Give me a reason. Nope, can't even add knowledge to it yet. I can't go into my settings anywhere and just, nope, there's no way there's nothing. Okay, cool. They wrote a list here. It's not bad, like, but it's just a ChatGPT wrapper that you're allowed to, you know, expand on and whatnot with these prompts and everything. I just don't care. You know why? Because everyone's individual and nothing about this is individual. I can't even move this stuff into databases easily, right? Like you'd think that'd even be an option. But with Taskade, I have the ability to literally create AI agents with custom profiles. If I go into edit agent here, you can see that I can make a project management agent. I give it specific instructions. There's a bunch of templates to choose from. There's a bunch of prompt templates to choose from. Not even close to the same amount as in Notion. I mean, we're talking like 10 times, 20 times the amount. Actually, I might be undershooting. It's probably like 50 times. And you also have the ability to add custom commands to it. You also have the ability to upload knowledge like a YouTube video that then gets transcribed, like a link to a website that gives more context. Like if I go to riseproductive.com, and I go to the fact that I have content services here, I could go to my researcher and I could make a complete custom bot by adding the content services context. All right, then I can go to the general. You're a researcher, your task is to conduct in-depth on various topics. The main focus is to research for a content services company, Rise Productive, in order to reach a larger number of clients. Now imagine me giving it the ability to search the web. That sounds like it would make sense. So for example, this custom command could give it industry knowledge check. I could make it a background task. I could press web search. I can use knowledge. And then from there I could say, look into the industry standards based on the topic referenced in this AI prompt for content services that include video editing, thumbnail editing, social media management, and newsletter writing. So, for example, with Investigate, now what I can do by pressing update is I could go to my projects and say I want to make a marketing campaign, right? So let's click on this guy and do Investigate. which is what I just checked. So launch marketing campaign, right? Like I want to do some research on it. I should do content creation with impact, emphasize how Rise Productive can create original content that resonates with audiences, how we expand reach and drive growth. All of these different things are things from the website that it's referencing. So what I can do here is I can click on that, just pressing investigate, then allows me to use these custom prompts that I've made with the context that I've given it. Whereas Notion, I just would simply have, you know, the generic baseline of information that's coming from the page you're on, as well as, you know, the ChatGPT layer that they're putting on. To me, that's just a little bit frustrating, right? Like Notion's a $10 billion company and they can't add basic things like knowledge uploads or custom Notion AI personalities. Like, add those yesterday. I know it's not all text inside of Notion and the database references make a little bit sense as to why they're weird, but you know, the fact that I could just add this and then hide it just makes sense, you know? Or if I just do something like investigate, and I can also interact with a lot of the AI functionality here. Like I could ask project, or I could just click researcher and then use one of these like forecast trends. Obviously I could make more of these commands for it to automatically do. You kind of get the point, right? Like the ability for it to just choose one of these prompts, interact. And another really cool feature is I can do the following. I could also do slash within one of these and then click investigate. Another thing that I can do that's really cool is I can do backslash and then pick one of these prompts. And you'll notice now that this agent's going and it's working. I click off of it. Since I made that background task update, you can see that it's actually doing stuff in the background. That's right. I can have multiple of these running at once. Investigate, investigate. Then if I click on it, I can check the status. This is crazy. You can do multiple prompts at once. You can make your own little army of agents. I mean, this stuff's unlimited. This stuff is just without comparison to Notion. Kind of irritates me as a huge Notion fan and as a guy who's been using it for so long. Why can't Notion just add stuff like this? Why do they ship so much differently than other products? I don't know. I mean, Taskade is on the forefront of AI and they're definitely doing amazing stuff. So I don't want to put someone down to put someone else up, but it just frustrates me as a longtime user. I really like what Taskade's doing. Thank you for sponsoring the video, but these are all genuine reasons why the AI experience is better in Taskade than it is in Notion AI. That being said, thank you so much for watching this video. Check out this video on how to improve your skills using productivity tools even more.